Hello out there, shalom. My name is Damian Powell, and my website is YeshuaSavesAll.com. I have a broadcast that I've done on Periscope. I'm trying to bring that over to YouTube for anybody who's not familiar with me. You know, the name of the Father, the world calls him God. I call him Yahweh, hallelujah, the short form of his name that you're saying for Yahweh. And the world calls him Jesus, but I call him by his Hebrew name, Yeshua, which means salvation. The purpose of my ministry is to expose the darkness, okay, with the light of Yeshua, who is the way, the truth, and the life, okay? He is the Messiah, he's the Savior, he's the Son of Yahweh. And the thing that I want people to understand is that this world is just like the days of Noah. They have forgotten how holy our Elohim of Israel is. They've forgotten how holy God is. And people want to bring him down to our level when we should be climbing up to get to his. So the thing that I wanted to discuss today was the fallen angels. The fallen angels are now attacking your children. Beware. And you understand what I'm saying if you bear with me on this topic, okay? And a previous broadcast that I did on Periscope, if you go to my website, you can click on the Periscope link. I titled it, Throw Away Your TVs, The Darkness Surrounding the Movie Industry. And in that broadcast, I discuss how Los Angeles, California is also called El Pueblo de la Reina de Los Angeles, Sobre el Rio de Porcelina, which means the town of the Queen of Angels. Others say it means the Queen of Heaven or Lady the Queen. And as I explained, the Queen of Heaven is found in the Bible, is found in Scripture, so it's not something that's made up. If you go to Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 18, it says, the children are gathering wood, the dads are lighting the fire, and the women are kneading the dough to make cakes for the Queen of Heaven and to pour out drink offerings to other mighty ones, to other gods, to provoke me. Then Jeremiah 44, verse 17 says, but we shall do whatever has gone out of our mouth, to burn incense to the Queen of the Heavens and to pour out drink offerings to her as that we have done. And we and our ancestors, our kings, our heads in the cities of Judah and the streets of Jerusalem. So the Queen of Heaven is the one known as Easter, Ashtaroth, Astarte, Ishtar, Isis, Rhea, etc. The one who is being worshipped on Easter, Mother's Day, and a whole host of other pagan days, along with a son slash husband named Nimrod, a.k.a. Baal. As I explained in that broadcast, it is no coincidence that Hollywood, which is a derivative from the Greek Hollywood, is the home of the fallen angels in California. They placed the movie industry there for a reason. It's not a coincidence, okay? They placed this knockoff Hollywood in the city of the fallen angels for a reason, because it is a gateway for demonic spirits and activities to be released into this world. Satan was a fallen angel, and he took one third of the angels, the Malachim, with him. And they're losing battle in heaven, and now he and his fallen angels want to be worshipped as Elohim, gods. And they do it in an indirect fashion through spell casting, using entertainment through the movies and the music. Remember, Satan is the god of this world, so we are in his arena. California has a theme of darkness surrounding it, so he is using certain parts of California for his agenda. Now, I will explain. Like I said, you have the movie industry over there in Los Angeles, California. You also have the Bohemian Grove in California, okay, where the Illuminati elite and other powers of this world go to worship before a 40-foot owl, which is a representative of Satan, and to commit human sacrifices, chants, oaths, to devise plans against the deceived people of this earth. Satan requires human sacrifices, as he did in the Bible when the children of Israel were passed through their children through the fire to Moloch for economic prosperity and power. The same thing is being done today in our modern society with the Bohemian Grove. These same people go on to become presidents, members of Congress, and other positions of power. The first thing I think of is, I don't know if anybody's ever seen that movie. I don't watch movies anymore or any secular music of this world. But when I was watching those movies, there was one in particular called Jennifer's Body. And I forget the name of the band, but they were looking to sacrifice a virgin to Satan so that their band could go on to become this popular band. Now, I know people are saying, you know, you see this all the time in movies. So people are thinking, oh, it's just harmless entertainment. They just came up with this brilliant idea so that we can be entertained. No, it's hiding in plain sight. They show you what has to happen in order to get power and economic prosperity. They sacrificed this girl thinking that she was a virgin so that their band could go on to become big time, okay? So they use that in that movie, Jennifer's Body, to show you that that's what they do in this world, in the Bohemian Grove and all these pagan holidays like Beltane and Halloween and Easter. All of these days, they're showing you what they are doing, okay? So it's not something that you just came up with on the spot, okay? These demons and all that they've seen, that they make in these movies, are demons that they have actually seen in real life, okay? So these human sacrifices are real. They do it in the Bohemian Grove in California, okay? And like I said, it's just recreating pagan rituals that went on in scripture, okay, where they sacrificed their children to Moloch. Also in California, they are trying to indirectly ban the Bible. There is a bill in California called the Assembly Bill 2943 that is being proposed to set restrictions on services to change a person's sexual orientation, also known as gay conversion therapy. Current state law prohibits sexual orientation change or efforts for children under the age of 18. This means that the bill is currently awaiting the vote in the state Senate. All right, listen to this. The San Diego Union Tribune reports Assemblyman Travis Allen, who is running for governor in California, as saying, quote, the bill would literally ban Bible sales, okay? And then the reporter of OANN host Liz Wheeler says, this is essentially criminalizing religious beliefs. And I don't mean to speak in hyperbole here, but if this bill were to pass, wouldn't this bill prohibit the sale of Bibles that teaches that these things about sexual morality? Well, literally, according to how this law is written, yes, it would, Allen replied. This is, you know, PC culture, politically correct culture gone horribly awry. This is really directly hitting at our First Amendment right as American citizens. These so-called rights they are trying to pass to protect children by banning books to change a person's sexual orientation goes against saving that individual from what Yahweh calls an abomination. Why wouldn't we want to save these people instead of banning material that would help them? You are keeping the light of his word, the Bible, in the darkness by doing this, by trying to ban it, this bill that they're trying to pass. Chapter 5, verse 20 through 21 says, woe to those who call evil good and good evil, who put darkness before light and lightness for darkness, who put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter, Woe to those who are wise in their own eyes and clever in their own sight. Isn't that what this world is doing, being wise in their own eyes by trying to ban the Bible, being clever in their own sight by trying to ban the Bible, which speaks out against these practices? And you are trying to ban these materials so that you can keep that person from walking in darkness, to keep that person walking in darkness by saying you can't convert them from whatever sexual orientation they pick. Our Elohim destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah for these abominable practices. And Paul spoke out against this in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. Do you not know that the unrighteous shall not inherit the reign of Elohim, God? Do not be deceived. Neither those who whore, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor homosexuals, not thieves, nor greedy of gain, nor drunkards, nor revilers or swindlers shall inherit the reign of Elohim. So homosexuals have been classed in the same category as idolaters, adulterers, those who whore, those who are greedy, and those who are drunk. Okay, so don't ban the Bible when they need to know these things. The Bible is the light. It is the lamp unto our feet. So why hide this knowledge from them who need to hear this? Why ban any books that can change the mind of a child from their brainwashed, indoctrinated state that the world has taught them before they were even to think for themselves? Their agenda is being pushed in the music, the movies, and all over our society. Okay? So that's the third thing in California that's going on. And mind you, that it's just going to start there. They pass these laws, and then it's going to trickle down to all states, and everybody's going to heed to it. Okay, now the other thing is, will your child be forced to listen to abominations in school? They've already taught children plenty of abominations in school, but here's another one. Listen to this. In California, there is a sex ed controversy in the schools. They are talking to kindergartners about gender identity. The children haven't even figured out what they are going to be when they grow up first to even teach them about gender identity. It's a brainwashing technique used in our society. They are also teaching children same-sex practices for LGBTQ high schoolers and addressing masturbation with the middle school children, which is a form of sexual immorality that is going to lead to pornographic addiction and other materials. And sadly, there are parents out there who are agreeing with this. This is what they're teaching in the schools in California. Now listen to this. Jonathan Keller, a president and CEO of Family Council, says that the state will be institutionalizing a graphic and obscene nature of this material by having it taught in the classroom is disturbing, he says. Heller says that a lot of parents are not well off to put them into private schools or to homeschool them. He says, I personally think that this is how Satan traps the world by making us think that there are no other options available. You will be forced to feed your children lies like the schools do with the pagan holidays and taking prayer out of schools. These schools teach your children how to practice Christmas, Easter, Halloween, Thanksgiving, all of Satan's pagan days, his holidays, but they don't teach you any of Yahweh's holy days. So that's another lie that they've taught you. Keller also says that gender identity, gender ideology will be forced on the children. Your gender isn't based on biology, but how you are feeling. And what is sad is that parents will not be able to opt out of this teaching in the schools. So your child will be forced to listen to gender identity teachings at the age of 5 and masturbation for your middle school children. In the beginning, Elohim created male and female. Okay, therefore, Elohim did not make a mistake when he made anyone. He is perfect. So how are we going to allow schools to teach your children that I can be whatever I want to be? My gender is not based on biology, but how I'm feeling. The other reporter says that these teachings will provide a framework, provide information and resources to say that traits don't define gender. You are the gender in which you identify with, and those traits are only things that you like. Now, to sum up everything that I just said, is there any coincidence that the four topics I mentioned in this broadcast are birth in California, the home of the fallen angels, the queen of heaven? The portal is being opened wider as the darkness of this world gets darker. The school system is forcing vaccines on your children that contain aborted baby fetuses and pigs and all these other abominations. Now they're going to force your child to listen to gender identity, okay? They're teaching your children all the pagan days that are not in scripture. Like I said, it's no coincidence that the movie industry is set in California. The Bohemian Grove is set in California. They're trying to ban Bibles in California. Now they're going to teach your children gender identity in California, which is the home of the fallen angels. So it's like a demonic gateway. And now the gate is being opened wider and wider. So the apostate generation can come in and people will fall away from the faith. How strong are you going to be? I want us to all to stand up in the light of Yeshua, because he's the light of this world for all the darkness that surrounds us. Okay, so that's all I have today. I pray that this broadcast has helped you. If you, I would like you, or I pray that you would share this with people who are unaware. Subscribe to the channel. Go to the website, yeshuasaysall.com, and download the book that I have up there for PDF completely free, and let us stand together in the body of Messiah. Let us pray together. If you have any questions, feel free to email me. Plenty more broadcasts to come, Elohim willing. But as I said, share this, subscribe, check out the website, okay? Again, thank you for listening. Again, my name is Damian Powell, representative servant of Yeshua. Amen. Thanks again.